fellow audience.
Today we are interviewing a famous,
most talented
author. So tell me, Eva, who is this most talented, most famous author?
Well, he's recently made this new book called Candid 3.
Oh, that's cool, but I don't really know a lot of information. Could you give me another clue?
Well, he likes playing video games, Sonic the Hedgehog, and Mario. P.S. If you look on his Instagram, you can see that he loves burgers.
Oh, I remember. He starts with an O and his surname starts with a P. It's
Phommavanh! Well, here he is. We would love to ask these 10 amazing questions to him.
And I hope you guys love it as much as we do.
So let's get started. How do you make your story so interesting?
What I do is I usually use all the things in my head, so my rocky imagination. And then I also think about what happened to me when I was a kid. So my embarrassing family, all my cool friends, the things I loved to do when I was a kid. And I combine all those together and then I work out the most interesting part about that. So I basically write about weird people and then I write about strange friendships. That's all my books are all about.
Cool. When did you start writing books?
I started writing books 10 years ago, back in 2007. I decided to quit full-time teaching and become a writer. And that means that I could be home all day, playing with toys, playing games, and doing a little bit of writing. So that was the plan.
What inspired you to write?
I think for me, when I was a kid, I used to love reading books. And so my favorite authors were Roald Dahl, Paul Jennings, Morris Glassman, and Andy Griffiths. And when I read those books, I thought, how cool would it be to actually be a writer, to make stuff up, make people laugh? And I also was writing really strange stories about, you know, random toys and all this kind of stuff as well. And so I remember friends laughing that way. I thought, okay, I definitely want to be a writer, so yes.
Okay. On a scale of 1 to 10, how famous do you consider yourself?
I think I would probably be a 3 or 4.
What?
Because even though I'm well known in the book world, I can still walk down the street and no one knows who I am. So, and that's that's actually a good thing. Because I like being famous in the book world. I like going to schools and they know me and it's pretty cool. But I like the fact that I can still walk down the street and no one will bother me. But yeah, hey, that said, if I ever become that famous, that'd be really cool as well, because I don't care, I'm in the money, so that'd be good. But yes, I'm probably 3 or 4, but yeah.
How long does it take to write a book, and which one took the longest to write?
It takes me about 6 months to write a book. So Penguin say to me, Oliver, this book is due in July or August, you're going to get it done? And I'm like, yeah, that's okay. And then 5 months later, I'm like, oh no, don't even get it on! So that's what usually happens. Nobody's Prefect, with the book that I've just finished, that probably took me the longest because I started work on it like 5 years ago and then it got rejected once and then okay, I'll take it back and then I'll write it again. And then I give it back to Penguin and said, rejected again. And I'm like, oh no. And so I had to really think really hard about how to make the story really good. And so that probably took me the longest to write. So that's like, yeah, 3-4 years now took me to write. So that's probably the longest book to write. Yeah.
What is your favourite book you have written so far?
The favourite book that I've written so far would have to be a tie between Tyrific, which is my first book, and Con Nerd, which is a book about being a nerd, and that's why I like Super Con Nerd, because it's really cool to write. But also, I really also enjoyed writing The Other Christie as well, because it's a sweet story about two girls, so they become best friends.
I thought there was grammar mistakes in your book.
I deny all these allegations. I don't know what you're talking about at all.
Okay, show you.
Oh no! Really? What kind of mistakes are there in my precious books? Oh, you've even bookmarked them as well.
Yeah.
To show the shame.
I read the whole book.
Oh, you read the whole book? Did you like the book?
Yeah, it's
very
good.
And he was reading this one. I'm reading Punchlines.
Oh, okay. Oh, Punchlines is a good book too.
So, you said, when do you get to draw?
What was this?
Here. In the art club.
When do you begin? That's because he was so nervous that, because this is when he was like knocking his pencils over. So he's like, oh, when do we get to draw? That was a flat out mistake. So that's okay. To all my tree tree gum gums over there. I think because at the last part, right, before the book gets printed, my editor would say, okay, Oliver, read this, proofread it, and make sure there's no mistakes. And when you've read a book so many times, they're like, oh yeah, things should be okay, but then like give me some stuff like that. That's pretty sad, but that's okay. It'll be alright. Yes, and as long as it's nothing major. So let's see.
Alright, and then it says, she drops it onto my palm and I break it off.
Let's see.
I break it off.
She drops it onto my palm and I break it in half. I break it half. That's like slang. It's like, yo, what up, man? I break it half. You know what up, man? I break it half. That's like, you know, because we don't have to use proper words like in and stuff like that. So, yeah, that's also another mistake as well. So, yes, that's right. So, you know what? Maybe when my next book comes out, would you like to be proofreaders? Would you like to look through my story and see if there are any mistakes there?
Oh, I kind of need my mum too.
You can get your mum. You can also get... I know some other people who would love to look at my books and find them, and get a comment and find them. But yeah, so yeah, that's true. There's a lot of mistakes in my books. So, but you know, it's just the way it is, I guess. But you know what? Even since the original book, there was also mistakes in there too. But it can't be helped. That's okay.
So, how does one become an author?
How does one become an author? You know what? All you can do is just write. It's easy as that. Like, I think all you can do is just write a story, finish it, and then from there you can. Give it to a publisher, you can publish it yourself, or you can get some advice about it and get your book out there. Yeah, so I think for if you want to be a writer for real, like into competitions, so you can get some cool prizes and some credibility, but also every single website now has a website, and has a page telling you how to get your story published, and basically you just email them the idea, and if they like that, they'll ask for the whole book. So easy as that. But you've got to write the book first, that's step number one.
When you were younger, did you go to a selective high school?
No, I didn't. But I did try 3 times and I didn't make it. So I tried in year 6. Nope. I tried again when I was in year 9. Nope. And then let you try again once more time in year 10.
Wow.
And nope as well. So yeah, so I only did the 3 times, but that's okay.
Besides writing, what are your other favourite hobbies?
Well, like you said, I like eating burgers. I love burgers so much. In fact, I'm thinking about eating a burger right now. No. And I also like playing lots of games, as you can probably tell. I love my Nintendo Switch, I love my Wii U, and my Xbox One, and my Xbox 360, and my 3DS. And I basically what I do is that this job is basically, I do this job so I can play more games. That's basically it. So that's why I love it. And I also love to read too. So I like reading video game magazines. And also like reading other people's books as well. So yes, so I like to read books to help me write my stories. And that's also a pretty good thing to do. Like the more books you read, the more you get an understanding of what's out there. So yes.
Well, thank you for listening to these 10 amazing questions with us.
And also thank all of our Phommavanh for being here with us.
Yay. We hope that you learned something new today about all of our Phommavanh. Bye!